All right, so I just wanted to take a couple minutes here and talk about this problem here. So finding the escape velocity of helium atoms, right? So in order to escape Earth's gravity, an object near the top of the atmosphere, so about 100 kilometers from Earth's surface, must travel away from the Earth at 11 kilometers per second in order to escape Earth's gravity, right? So this is called the escape velocity. So the question here is that what temperature would helium atoms have at RMS speed equal to this escape velocity? All right, so this is saying that helium atoms, they're going to escape if they're going that fast, 11.1 kilometers per second. So what temperature would these atoms have in order to achieve this? All right, so I thought we might be first just kind of refresh our memory of how this escape velocity value could have been found. Like, how do we know it's 11.1 kilometers per second? Right, so if we remember from circular motion, right, so an object that's in an orbit around the Earth, so a satellite, is only under the effect of the force of gravity, right? Well, so then applying Newton's second law, that force is mass times acceleration. Our acceleration is only centripetal acceleration, v squared over r. So we have here, well, since the only force acting on the satellite is the force of gravity, I wrote the general form of the gravitational force. So capital G being the gravitational constant, mm over r squared. So the big M representing, so these are the mass of the two objects interacting gravitationally. So big M typically we're representing this would be the Earth, and little m would be the whatever the object is that's orbiting the Earth. And r is the distance from the center of the Earth to the center of the orbiting object. And this would then be equal to mv squared over r, again, where this m is the mass of the satellite, the orbiting object. We can rearrange this equation, right? So our little m's cancel since those are the same mass. One of the r's cancel. Solving for the speed is going to be the square root of 2g big M over r. So gravitational constant, mass of the Earth, distance from the center of the Earth to the object. So using this, we see that this speed is independent of whatever the object is. So that's pretty cool. So that's why the prompt here didn't say what the object was. It said any object has to be moving at that speed, right? So if you plug in the mass of the Earth and altitude of 100 kilometers, though of course we have to do it to the center of the Earth, so we add the radius of the Earth there too, we end up with 11.1 kilometers per second. So another thing that might be useful to us, so I'm kind of leading us into this way. So I just set here the force of gravity equal to force of gravity, right? So left here I have kind of the first way we learned. So if we have a region of a gravitational field with uniform gravitational acceleration, we have value of mg, and that was equal to gm over r squared. So we can solve for g big M. And we see again little m's cancel, and so g times big N is also little g times r squared. This can be useful because sometimes you might want to find velocity in terms of in some uniform gravitational field, so where g is constant. The thing is, when you get far away from the surface of the Earth, the value of gravitational acceleration becomes very small. But that's what this line over here is basically referencing. We could write that the escape velocity, we could write in either the general form or as 2g over r. And that's using basically plugging in gm being gr squared. And it simplifies to this. So overall, this problem actually isn't too difficult. I did all this backstory that was relatively unnecessary. But we know the speed that we're dealing with, I converted that from kilometers per second to meters per second, and we're trying to find temperature. Well, we have the relationship that the RMS speed is equal to the square root of 3 kT over m. But Boltzmann's constant is another thing that we know. So what I'm doing here is I'm squaring both sides. And here I can actually rearrange and I end up with this formula over here. So temperature is mv squared over 3k. So looking at this, well, vrms, we know. K, the Boltzmann constant, we know. So the only thing we need to figure out is this m, which is the molar mass. Not the molar mass, that's just the mass that we're dealing with. For a helium atom, not helium molecule, we're looking at atoms here. So to find the mass that we need, the mass of one molecule, we're taking the molar mass and dividing by the number of atoms per molecule, right? So the molar mass I just looked up in our periodic table, divided by Avogadro's number, giving us a mass for a helium atom being 6.65 times 10 to the negative 27 kilograms. So then now I can plug in all my numbers here using K, that's in SI units, giving us a value of what are my units there? 1.98 times 10 to the 4 Kelvin. Why did I write kilograms? Oh, that gives me a good chuckle. All right, pretend that's Kelvin, not kilograms. So it's a very high temperature, right? So these, in order to get for these helium atoms to escape, they have to have a really high temperature, right? So this is why kind of our atmosphere is the way it is, because these molecules have to get to a super high temperature in order to escape. So most of them are not going to escape, which is good, right? So that means we can survive on our planet. Or I guess it's more of we've survived because of this phenomena, because we've adapted to that. This biology, you guys can deal with that. All right, so the question is, the acceleration due to gravity on the moon is 1/6 that of Earth, right? So is this going to affect the escape velocity? So hopefully you're thinking, well, yeah, of course, right? Just on the previous slide, we did the quick derivation that the escape velocity is the square root of 2gr. So if the value of our gravitational acceleration becomes 1/6, then our escape velocity is going to decrease as well. It's going to decrease by the square root of 6. Excuse me. I've been talking a lot today, a lot of video recordings. So how do you think this applies to the lack of the atmosphere on the moon? Well, this basically explains why there is no atmosphere on the moon, right? Because the escape velocity for any atoms or molecules, gas molecules that are there, they don't have to go very fast in order to escape, right? So the moon cannot keep an atmosphere because of that. So I think that's a pretty interesting consequence, right? And this is why on the moon that there you don't see a quote-unquote sky, right? Because there's no gas molecules in order for light to scatter and interact with, causing there to be a color. We'll get more into that when we get into optics, but there's no atmosphere, so there's no gas molecules to scatter sunlight, so there's no sky.